Please welcome to the ring now, the fighting pride of East London, England, Kevin Mitchell!
Well, last time we saw it was 8 months ago and he boxed to perfection against Ghislaine Maduma. To come from behind and force an 11th round stoppage. But it has to be noted that twice on the big stage he's fallen apart under pressure. It happened against Michael Katsidis, it happened against Ricky Burns. It cannot happen tonight. But all the talk is that he's been very focused, very dedicated. Is that going to be enough against an extremely capable opponent tonight?
Well, that's true. You know, two big chances have gone astray. It was what it is. It's not bad losing in big fights, but he just simply didn't perform. That was the big problem. But I think he's in a better place now. He's 30 years of age. He's back with Tony Simmons, who trained him in his amateur days. So I think everything is switched on for Kevin at this moment in his career. I think he knows it's his last chance. I think he knows if he doesn't perform tonight, it's all over. But I still look upon this as a real tough match for him.
A tough match, but a great opportunity as well, because a shot at the world title awaits the winner. And you can see, look at the height, Daniel Estrada 5'10.5, Mitchell 5'8, and Estrada has a long right lead. His reach significant as well, and that's going to be one of the key features of this fight. If Mitchell can deal with that right hand, if he can't, he's in trouble. Similar experience. One of the bookies make of this. They're usually right. They fancy Mitchell big time. That is not a view that is shared by some at ringside.
Introducing to you, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the red trunks trimmed with white and green, weighing in at 9 stone, 8 pounds, 3 ounces, with a 36 fight record, 32 wins, 24 inside the scheduled distance, 3 defeats, 1 draw. From Mexico City, Mexico, where he is known as Tremendo Daniel Estrada! And ladies and gentlemen, here he is! Fighting out of the blue corner, where the blue trunks are in a nice down, 8 pounds, 1 ounce. For a 45 record with 38 wins, 28 inside the scheduled distance. And just 2 defeats. He comes to the ring as the former British and Commonwealth Super Featherweight Champion and World Title Challenger. He is the fighting pride of East London, England! Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, here he is, Kevin Mitchell! So time to get the action underway with 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC Silver Lightweight Championship.
Behind the referee, I suppose you're both in the dressing room. Obey my command at all times. You both know the rules. What's the heads? Now kick the punches up. And when I shout break, you break clean. And remember, defend yourselves at all times. Shake hands.
It's very simple for both these men. Defeat unthinkable. Kevin Mitchell has already said, end of the line if I lose right now. And for this fella, after losing last time out in his world title shot, another defeat will push him a long way down the queue. Two men need this title.
Seconds out, first round.
And this opportunity very, very badly indeed. Will it be Kevin Mitchell, the shorter man in the blue, or will it be the Mexican, Daniel Estrada, the tall man who has that long lead? Mitchell's going to have to solve that. And he also may have a weight advantage in there as well, Jim. When we saw him against Figueroa back in the summer, he put on 19 pounds after the weigh-in.
Well, I think Kevin puts on a fair amount too, but I don't think he puts on as much as that. Estrada has the longer reach. I think Mitchell's maybe a little bit quicker with these punches. So we need a disciplined performance from Mitchell like we saw. You know, we've actually seen a couple. You know, Bradis Prescott, for example, where he really thought his way around the whole fight. That's what he's going to have to do here. He's going to have to get involved some of the time. But he's looking positive in the early stages. you know, bobbing, weaving, ducking, diving, getting some nice punches off.
And the Maduma fight as well, very, very controlled. Even though he was losing that fight, he didn't panic, he stuck with the game plan.
Yeah, I didn't look upon that as one of his best performances. He came from behind Maduma. Run out of steam in the last couple of rounds. It was a great turnaround. I think he'll have to box better here tonight, but this is a positive start. He's looking sharp, that's good.
Yeah, that's another nice left-hand, very bright start this. I went down a couple of weeks ago to watch him spar. He sparred Richard Comey, the Commonwealth champion. What a useful fighter he is in his own right. They were working on head movement, just slipping inside that lead and then just unloading your shots and getting out of range and just regrouping again, but it was all about movement.
I think it's a good plan to frustrate this fellow, and I think that's what Mitchell's doing in the opening round, getting little quick punches off. Look, oh,
that's
good,
nice.
Stuff, terrific stuff.
Really good stuff this from Mitchell.
Yep, as I say, he's quicker than Estrada. Estrada throws him wide and wild at times. But if this is still going on after the halfway stage, that could have come. That's
oh, he's picking, he is picking some beauties right now, Kevin Mitchell. Can he carry on like this?
How confident is he looking at the moment? That's terrific.
Well, there's all this talk about he falls apart under pressure. I was talking to Glenn McCrory about this, and obviously he's right. You look at his record, he's right. But he wasn't living right in those days. He is living properly now. I mean, if he loses, he's going to lose to a better man. It's not because he's been cutting corners and doing crazy things.
Estrada has a frustrating opening round.
Mitchell almost landing the left-hand counter there, but the eye, oh, he's in there first and fast, Mitchell. All the eye-catching stuff in this opening session has come from the East Londoner. And again, look at the head movement there as he tried to land a left jab. He couldn't land either, he threw two and they both missed. Good start, Mitchell.
Well, I think Mitchell used the difference in height more to his advantage than a disadvantage in the opening round. He kept himself nice and low,
corners,
and he took some really beautiful, cheeky little punches. Look at that, leading with a left uppercut. Terrific stuff, really confident look about his work.
Round two of this 12-rounder. There is a belt on the line, the WBC silver belt. Far more meaningful, it's an eliminator for the title held by Jorge Linares. An awful lot of boxing experts reckon that Linares is not going to be there for long. But the winner of this one, whoever it is, would have a very, very good chance against a guy who's moved up through the weights. Long way to go, but a bright, bright start indeed from Mitchell, who is boxing to the game plan that Tony Sims set down. Can he keep it going? Estrada looked really slow with that right hand that missed by a mile. He's out of range. When you know, he talked about this earlier, Jim, you know, he's the taller man, he's got the long levers, but he just can't find his range at the moment.
So he held that punch back. He knew before he let it go that it wasn't going to land. The lead missed by a mile. He just held the right hand back, so he knows he has what to do. He knows how to solve this fellow out. So single punches, I'm sure they'll have been told in the corner, single punch is no good. Mitchell is a beautiful counter puncher tonight, so you don't throw single punches to a counter puncher. So you need to raise the tempo. The tempo in the opening round suited Mitchell. A little bit better from Estrada here.
Yeah, if that long left gets going, Mitchell will be in trouble. He cannot allow him to establish that jab. So far, the Mexican can't. And again, Mitchell with the sharp, eye-catching stuff. Good work with the left hand from Mitchell.
See, that's what you wanted. You don't get involved. Just throw the punches that the judges remember when the bell rings. If you're taking nothing and you're landing classy little shots, you're going to win the round.
Oozing confidence as well, isn't he, at the moment? Really looking good in there, Mitchell. Again, a big assault from Estrada. Very little landed. Mitchell looking really comfortable, and Estrada needs to warn guard against frustration here. He might open himself up and get caught.
The trouble for Estrada is going to have to be a little bit cavalier. He's going to have to let some punches go. He's been outboxed here. Outthought as well. This is terrific stuff from Mitchell. This is the kind of performance we were hoping for. Hopefully he can keep it going.
The talent has always been there from Kevin Mitchell. You talk to people around the game, they rate him so highly for his skill. It's talent unfulfilled up till now. Is he going to get it right at last? So far, so good for Kevin Mitchell. Eye-catching, confident, composed.
Yeah, but I'm sure you'll just be told more of the same. Concentration tonight is of ultimate importance. Don't do anything silly, don't take any chances. But he has the power to hurt this man as well. So the longer it goes, the more meat you can expect him to put into his punches.
Round three.
Mitchell's connections also watched that fight. Estrada with Omar Figueroa back in the summer, and they wondered how he would cope under pressure, because they thought he folded a little bit in that fight right at the end. And maybe Mitchell can get to him. So disheartening, Estrada also part of the game plan. He must be pretty disheartened with what he's done so far, or what he hasn't done, but still a long, long way to go.
He's trying little feints now. He's obviously getting good advice in the corner. The body shot was good. I think it was partly blocked, though.
Mitchell had a body shot of his own earlier. Fighting in little flurries. Look at the fierce determination on the face of Estrada. Mitchell catching him once again. Oh, catching him clean on the floor, Estrada. Well, it was bad for the Mexican before. It just got a whole lot worse. And you talked about it, Jimmy. He was going to take some risks, get a bit cavalier, and it would mean it was open. He got up quickly.
He's badly shaken by that shot. I don't think his head is cleared yet. His legs aren't looking strong. He's on the defensive. He's experienced.
And Mitchell
shot.
Pouring it on. Another big left hand. Estrada hanging on at the moment. Again, punishing him with the counters. Oh, now Mitchell staggered. Estrada caught Mitchell. That just changed the game plan.
Just as I say, Nick, concentration is of ultimate importance, especially when you've got the other guy hurt and he's desperate. Just a little reminder there for Mitchell. He scored the knockdown, it's a big round.
Real nice slicing, accurate stuff from Mitchell, who's recovered his legs. I don't know if he just got his legs crossed up and stumbled, or whether he was actually stunned, but whatever, he seems to have regrouped. And Estrada shipping some heavy shots there, especially with the left hand. What a spearing jab. And Mitchell left himself open there, but managed to close in and get inside before he could get caught with a counter.
This is as good as I've seen Kevin Mitchell. This is terrific, because this is at the top level.
I'll tell you, the legs stiffened up there again from Estrada when he was caught with that combination. Well, Estrada, when he opened up last time, ended up on the floor. And he's taking punishment here after he opened up. And looking really ragged.
Well, after the opening round, I didn't think things would get any better for Kevin Mitchell. This is terrific.
Big, big left hand again, and Estrada sucking it all up. But a disastrous round for the Mexican, absolutely disastrous.
Not just everything has fallen into place for Kevin Mitchell tonight, a long last. Terrific shot, right hand. Okay, it did catch Estrada a little bit square-footed, he was on his heels already. But no, that was a knockdown punch, no question. And you can see when I get back up, the experience, he knew he was shaking, his legs weren't strong, so he went onto the defensive, but then, yeah, just a little stagger. That was a good shot in return from him. Yep, that was a good shot. Yep, you just saw the effect of that in the legs, but when you're in great shape, you throw the effects of a punch immediately, and that's what Kevin's done there.
He walked onto that one.
Second dance, round four.
Well, Estrada was a long way behind against Omar Figueroa in his last fight. He wasn't able to turn it around, but he stuck around and stuck around. You don't blow away Mexican lightweights easily. This fella is not going to get blown away. Nacho Beristain in the Estrada corner, telling his man, work the body, attack the Mitchell midsection.
You know, with that kind of cross-arm defence he's got, it's not easy to get to the body. Mitchell, a good head movement, he carries his left hand a little bit lower than I would like, but it's good for blocking body shots, or good work again from him.
He looks so fast. Mitchell, oh. And Estrada's just got no answer to these left hands. I know it was the right to put him down, but it's the left that he's really in a lot of work with here, Mitchell.
He's manoeuvring Estrada around the ring, which is a big plus. We thought Estrada would be naturally bigger than naturally stronger, but not. Mitchell's looking the boss. Perfect left hook again.
And I tell you, that long left hand of Estrada's has been a non-factor in this fight so far. You saw him throw it there, Mitchell just out of the way. Nice uppercut. Estrada looked to land a body shot afterwards. And Mitchell continues this systematic breakdown.
He's taking some chances himself, but they're paying off.
Yeah, you don't want to be going to war.
He's leaving his chin, you know, unprotected as he goes forward there.
Go to war with a Mexican, that is really rolling the dice. Estrada looked to try and land a body shot there, but again caught with a big right hand.
He just doesn't see the punches coming.
No. His upper
coming
body movement is really poor.
Well, there was never anything clever about what Estrada did. He was always pretty straightforward, but we didn't expect to see him outbox like this. He just can't land anything cleanly on Mitchell.
And that left hand, Mitchell has done a great job neutralizing it. Blocking it off. So he tries a right hand lead Estrada. That didn't work. Mitchell, I think, actually winked over at Judge John Keane, who sat in front of us. That's how comfortable he is at the moment. He had a glance over at John Keane and just winked to say, yep, I'm all right, I'm in control. Just stay concentrated.
And the head's coming together there. He seems stronger than the two. I mean, he just pushed Estrada back there. Little exchange of punches. He pushed them back.
Well, the best and most complete technical fight we've seen from Kevin Mitchell was the Prescott win all those years ago. This is right up there. That's a face of a guy who's having a bad night.
Yep, not a happy looking corner. No, he just doesn't know what to do. With Kevin Mitchell, he doesn't see the punches coming. When they land, they're shaking him up. Throwing punches back in desperation, not a hope of landing. Look at Mitchell, his eyes never leave the target.
Well, let's see if it carries on. Kevin Mitchell, superb through four rounds. Estrada is the man who needs to find something different. Make something happen. He was told to attack the body in the last round. Just wasn't able to get much success at all. The odd little punch getting through here and there, but Mitchell doing much the better work, much the busier, and totally in control. Estrada missing and missing, as he has done so often tonight.
I just wonder what the punch accuracy is for Mitchell. I mean, he just doesn't seem to miss, doesn't waste a thing. And it looks as though he can do this all night long, so relaxed.
And what about the punch accuracy from Estrada?
Non-existent,
yeah. There's nothing there. I mean, again, he's got that reach advantage and he's doing nothing with it. Mitchell giving him nothing. Just doing exactly what he wanted there. Launching the raid, getting out.
Always mindful about what's coming back.
Again, Estrada out of range.
Oh,
uppercut coming out of nowhere. Estrada didn't even see it.
It's actually a different class to Estrada here, and it's a different class altogether.
I mean, I don't remember Omar Figueroa beating him up as thoroughly as this. That really is saying something. He's out, up till now, he's outclassing this fella. Nothing doing again for Estrada. His punch accuracy, as you say, it's non-existent.
Mitchell just looks capable of taking it away from him anytime he pleases. Just gives him a little burst, bobs, weaves, blocks, then takes charge again.
Impossible to make a case for Estrada even having a share of a round so far, and there's a 10-8 round against him. That left uppercut of Mitchell's just keeps getting through, and Estrada just never sees it coming. The judges do.
Mitchell's actually treating him like a sparring partner. Oh. He's just going through the motions here. Just his concentration is superb.
Well, I tell
never
you,
takes his eyes off, but look at that, terrific.
Richard Comey in sparring was a lot more competitive than this fella is. Mitchell didn't have his way with Richard Comey the way he's having his way with Daniel Estrada. This is outstanding from Mitchell. Everything's gone right. That left uppercut is just a gem, isn't it?
Yep. Estrada doesn't see where the punches are coming from. There's a little feint and a dip just before he threw it. Okay, Estrada, to his credit, he's able to try to counter, but he's a mile off target with the counters.
Well, questions about Estrada's heart. No sign of that breaking yet. Mitchell has still got to keep working. We are not even at halfway yet, but he's got to find something different.
That was a solid jab. Even that punch was a sickener. Estrada walked right onto that.
Well, if Mitchell's out jabbing Estrada, what else can go wrong? And can't land a right hand Estrada. That left hand of Mitchell's was blocked off. Not many have been tonight.
See, it's the speed Mitchell has, so it's taking away any advantage of the reach that Estrada has. Mitchell's just too quick in every department. His punches are too quick. The head movement's too quick.
Well, make no mistake, Estrada came here to win. This is a massive, massive fight for a man who came close. You know, they talked about the fact that his sister had just died in a car crash prior to the Figueroa fight and how that must have affected his preparations. This is a guy whose only other defeats have been, well, one was an early career split decision over four rounds, we can discard that, and then a split decision against Sanchez Reyes, who's no mug either. So very, very close to elite level Estrada, but not showing it tonight, not at all. The elite performance is coming from Kevin Mitchell. Oh, brilliant stuff again. It's just outstanding from Mitchell, and those left uppercuts are a thing of beauty. Another left hand. Estrada is taking them though, but breathing very heavily.
But Mitchell's just chiseling away, just drilling the punches home, not looking for the stoppage. At this rate, the stoppage must come. No one can take as many clean punches, you know, without landing anything back. His heart must be broken, he's frustrated, he's hurt. So you just wonder how long this can continue.
I wonder if the nose might have gone as well, because he's really taking a beating there. He's just tattooing him, isn't he? Figueroa showing great heart, but just can't land clean, and just look at what's coming back at him. That was winging in these punches, Mitchell.
The defensive work as well from Mitchell there. See, he never takes his eyes off Estrada. Covers with the shoulder, covers his chin with the shoulder, sees what's coming, deals with it, and then gets his own punches off.
Another little jolting left hand inside. brilliant stuff again from Mitchell. That's how we're reading it. Ed, you're with Spencer.
Well, Kevin Mitchell's defence, his timing, his punch picking, it's a joy to watch, isn't it, Spencer?
Yeah, punch perfect in there at the moment. Probably one of the best I've seen Kevin perform. Estrada's no mug. You know, he's boxed for the world title before. He's only lost a couple of fights, and Mitchell really doing a number on him. Punch perfect.
He can't be complacent, though, can he? Because he was caught in the third round after scoring the knockdown.
Yeah, that's the only thing that he's got to be careful of, jumping in with those shots. You know, he's looking, he's picking the uppercuts beautifully. Does jump in sometimes, carrying his right hand low, leaving himself open to a left hook. That's the only criticism we could have of him at the moment. Tonight, you know, everything's been punch perfect, but he has got to be careful on the way in. But otherwise, you know, it's been brilliant.
Can Kevin force a stoppage as we go into the seventh round?
I think so. I think that, you know, he just needs to step it up another level. At the moment, he's boxing well within himself. As soon as we see him go through the gears, I think we're going to get the stoppage.
Thank you, Spencer.
Well, Estrada swelling badly around the right eye as well. Has to add to his problems. Real concern in the corner. While Spencer was talking, and Jim, no one's going to argue with that.
No, that's no surprise. Estrada doesn't even look like getting into this.
Still falling short, still missing. And the damage around that right eye is just getting worse and worse and worse, swelling over it and underneath it.
At this rate, Mitchell will break his heart, and it's much easier to score a stoppage when another fella's heart's broken, because he's just, he's lost in there. Estrada hasn't a clue what to do. He has to try to take the initiative more, you know, throw caution to the wind a little bit more than he's doing. I don't think it will work, but he has to try something else.
It's the only thing that's keeping him going, his heart, Estrada. An interesting point Spencer made about just going through the gears and finding another level for Kevin Mitchell. That's exactly what Figueroa did against Estrada after he was cut badly, if you remember. He came out, really turned it up a notch, and it was too hot for Estrada. And the stoppage was forced, but why would you change anything?
No, he'll just keep drilling away, chiseling away until he breaks all of the resistance. I fully expect the stoppage here. He's on the front foot a lot more now. Mitchell, you know, he was countering in the first few rounds, but now he's driving this fellow back. So going forward, there'll be more power in his own punches. The stoppage at the moment is looking on.
And tired looking punches from Estrada. Continuing just to measure him up again. That defensive work, that movement, that head movement that they've been working on diligently throughout the training camp.
Because he's doing everything at his own pace, I mean, he's not under any pressure. He can do this all night long. Estrada is not taking anything out of the tank. He's the one forcing everything.
Big right hand, Estrada just soaking it all up. Too easy for him, isn't it? Brilliant stuff again. It's like a razor just slicing into ribbons in there, Kevin Mitchell. Taking him apart systematically. And Estrada seemingly with no answers. Branning, actor Jake Wood in the house, and his birthday treat for his seven-year-old son today, Buster, and it's all a bit too much for him. Hopefully he's had a wonderful, wonderful night, but it's getting a bit late when you're 7 years old. Let's hope Kevin Mitchell doesn't fall asleep. That's surely the only way he's going to blow this. Seven rounds of total domination from Kevin Mitchell. And again, with the left hand, how would you compare this with the probably the best fight of his career, that demonstration against Bradis Prescott? Is this up there beyond that.
I think it's beyond that. It's beyond that because that was all kind of back foot boxing, you know, just careful stuff. I mean, he's dominating this guy. He's the boss. I mean, this is terrific. This is much better than the Prescott fight. Terrific.
Slicing him to ribbons. And for the first time, Ian John Lewis is taking a look at this. Mitchell goes for the finish. Estrada trying to hang in there, but he is taking a fearful pounding. And the referee having a real good look at this. Is Mitchell on the brink of a world title shot? Still a long way to go in this round.
Look how heavy-legged Estrada looks now. That's taken everything out of him, that burst. I don't think he has anything left.
Still trying to fire back. It's a brave, brave effort, this, from Estrada, because he's had nothing tonight. He's not been able to build on anything. Caught him again with a wicked one, and Ian John Lewis says that'll do it. What a win. What a performance from Kevin Mitchell. Outstanding. A statement fight at the age of 30. That is the best we've ever seen of Kevin Mitchell. Next stop, world title.
Well, you simply couldn't ask for anything more in a performance. That had everything. He took nothing. He drilled a proven world-class fighter. Proved he was a different class to that world-class fighter. Success is all about timing, and obviously timing. He's bang on perfect now for Kevin Mitchell. He's back with his original trainer, Tony Sims. He's happy. He's 30 years of age. He's not a kid anymore. He is more than ready now to challenge for the world championship again.
There will be some people saying, you know what, that stoppage was premature. No way. He was taking an absolute pounding in there. And Ian John Lewis did absolutely the right thing, because this was a brave, brave man that Kevin Mitchell has destroyed tonight.
Well, Nick, did you see Estrada complain when the referee waved it off? Not at all. No one can complain. It was one-sided. He was being beaten up. And Mitchell just put his pedal down on the gas, put full power into the shots now. No reason to allow this to continue. Ian John Lewis timed it perfectly. He took his time. I mean, he could have stepped in any time of it now, but no, he gave a world-class performer a chance to do the right thing, get himself back into the action. But look at that, when you see punches like that, nah, time to call it off. A good stoppage, perfect performance. Look at the blood all over Estrada. He was being taken to pieces there.
From first bell to last, he was on the receiving end of punches like that, and those left uppercuts, Mitchell couldn't miss. Brutal shot. Absolutely perfect stoppage. Punch perfect, Kevin Mitchell.
Ladies and gentlemen, timekeeper Michael McCann has recorded a time of 1 minute and 12 seconds of the 8th round. Our referee, Mr. Ian John Lewis, has stopped the contest. Estrada in no position to continue. Therefore, your winner and the new WBC Silver Lightweight Champion, the Fighting Pride of East London, England, Kevin Mitchell!
What a performance.
And ladies and gentlemen, what about the bravery?
And it was a brave effort from Estrada, but this was Kevin Mitchell's night. There were some who wondered how he would cope with the pressure. Would he be okay with it? Boy, we got the answer. I remember Glenn McCrory saying, well, you know what, this might be a tough night for Mitchell. Be interesting to hear what he says about it all, because Kevin Mitchell, if there were any critics out there, he's answered them and he's silenced them. Let's hear from him.
Well, Kevin, congratulations. Kevin, an electrifying performance. Was that the best showing of your career so far?
100%. You know, we worked very hard. I've got to thank for that man there. He works me like an animal. I have days where I'm moaning, tired, I'm knackered this and I'm knackered that. Get on with it. He pushes me. Ed was in the corner. Look at me. Look what you're doing tonight. The best I've ever fought.
Everything was perfect, wasn't it?
Yeah, you know, me and Tony have been working on some southpaw shots. Walking on to the left hand up for the middle. Long left. And it was working. You know, the shots Tony worked me on in the gym. Perfect. I thank this man, thank Eddie Earn, the team I've got around me with these two, the team I've got the boys in the gym, I'm unstoppable.
Tony, you worked with Kevin when he was a kid, when he was still an amateur. Has he reached his peak finally now?
I think he has, you know, he's had problems through his career, ups and downs. You know, the downs, when he got beat, he obviously weren't in shape and that was down to him. But, you know, he's back in love with the sport again, working with Matchroom. And, you know, he's a great fighter, Kevin Mitchell. He's definitely world title material. I've told him that all along. All he's got to do is get in shape, work hard in the gym. And he proves tonight he's different class, different class.
Let's have a word with the promoter, Eddie Hearn. Can you land a world title shot now for Kevin Mitchell?
He's the number one challenger to Jorge Linares. You know, we want that shot. He's such a class act, you know. There's not many lightweights in the world that can compete with him when he's in that kind of shape. And I'd be devastated if we didn't see him lift the world title. He's such a great grafter. And, you know, people talk about discipline. Since he's joined up with us, I've not seen anything but 100% discipline from Kevin Mitchell. And I will get him his world title shot, and I believe he's going to win one.
Over here, possibly?
Maybe. You know, look, he's a mandatory challenger. Jorge Linares. You know, you've got Richard Abril fighting soon over here. He's another target, but, you know, I've got to deliver a shot for Kevin Mitchell because I believe he can win a world title. And on that performance, I think he can beat any lightweight in the world. That was a career-best performance from Kevin Mitchell.
Kevin, how confident are you that you will win a world title this year, finally?
I'll win it. 30 years of age now, I've come into maturing myself as a person. I'm loving my work in the gym, letting my arms up really hard. This year, we're going to do it. I'm proving that. Look at all my career fights. Look how good I performed tonight. I can feel it in there, so you must be able to see it. So I haven't seen it yet, but if I can feel it, you must be able to see it.
What would it mean to you?
I mean my life. It means their life. It means everything. My kids. Everything I've ever dreamt of as a young kid of his age, 10, it would have been made off thanks to these lot. These men and this team I've got now makes me feel unstoppable.